Today's experiment is on pH and buffers. The first part is on pH. You will have 5 different solutions of known pH that you will put in a test tube. You're going to be adding color indicators to the test tubes. The color indicators are methyl orange, bromothymol blue, and phenolphthalein. So in your test tube, you'll put in 5 milliliters of a solution of pH 2, 2 drops of methyl orange, and you'll record the color it changes. I'm going to make up some data right now and pretend it changes red. I would take a new test tube and test solution with pH 4. And let's see, I get red again. I'm recording the color. And going on to pH 6, maybe that one turns green. Maybe 8 turns green. Again, this is made up data. And pH 10, this is blue. Okay, once I have my data in the data table in your notebook, you're going to transfer your data to the results section of your report sheet, and you're going to fill in this pH scale. So remember, our pH scale goes from 0 to 14. A solution with a pH of 7 is neutral. pH less than 7 means your solution is acidic. If your pH is greater than 7, your solution is basic. So what you'll do is any solutions that are the same color, you're going to color in your chart. So we're going to go from 2, we know that's red, 4 is red. So somewhere we're not sure exactly where the change is going to take place, this area is red. So you can either write in the word red if you don't have a colored pen, or you can color code it, whatever you prefer. And then between 6 and 8, we know it's green. So we're not sure exactly where it changes, so I'm just leaving a little space there. And we can color this in just green, or you could write that in. And then somewhere at pH 10, between 8 and 10, it turns blue. We're not sure how far that goes over. So I can just mark that there. The reason we're creating this color scheme here is if, for example, somebody came to you with an unknown compound, and you wanted to know if it was an acid or a base. So you could put your unknown compound in the test tube, add a color indicator, for example, methyl orange, put it in, see what color it changes. Somewhere it should be on this color scale that we have here. If it was to turn red, then we know our unknown is an acid. And we'd be able to report that results back to whoever wanted to know that information, or also how to dispose of that compound. So now let's take a look at our actual pHs of the solutions to get the true colors you will fill out. Now I'm going to go ahead and measure out 5 milliliters of my solution that's at pH 2. I'm going to use my small graduated cylinder. I want about approximately 5 mLs. We don't have to be exact. They should be about close to the same for all of them. So I have about 5 milliliters of my solution. Now I'm going to add 2 drops of my color indicator, 2 drops of methyl orange. And then you always want to make sure you swirl your solutions, and then you can record the color at pH 2. Now the other solutions, I've already measured out the 5 milliliters. So all I need to do is just add my 2 drops of phenolphthalein to each one. So this is pH 4. pH 6. And they're labeled MO for methyl orange. It's always important that you start with clean, labeled test tubes. Okay, so that's our series with the methyl orange. Our next color indicator is bromothymol blue. The first solution is pH 2. mixing the solution and then record the color. We have pH 4. pH 6. pH 8. pH 10. Now let's test our solutions with phenolphthalein. We'll put 2 drops in each one of the test tubes. You'll agitate them. Note the color. This is pH 4. pH 8. And pH 10. Part 2 of today's lab is on buffers. A buffer is a solution that is resistant to pH change when you add a strong acid or a strong base to it. Our buffer system in today's lab is a phosphate buffer. Buffers are comprised of a weak acid and their conjugate weak base. So the weak acid would react with a strong base that is represented here by hydroxide ions. So again, an acid is something that donates hydrogen ion or a proton to a base. So in this case, if we were to lose a hydrogen ion, it's being donated by the acid to the base. OH minus, we now have 2 hydrogens. We had a plus 1 from the hydrogen and a negative 1 cancel out to become neutral, so we get water. The weak acid, after it loses the hydrogen ion or the proton, is what we call the conjugate base. So in this case, we had 2 hydrogens. We remove 1, so we have 1 hydrogen. The phosphate PO4 stays the same. This was a negative 1 charge. We are losing hydrogen ion, so it's going to become more negative. So we get 2 minus here. So that's the conjugate base for my acid. Notice that this is the same here as my weak base in my phosphate buffer system. So my base in this case, if I added a strong acid to my system, we're representing this with the hydrogen ion, this represents my acid. The weak base, again, is the one that accepts the hydrogen ion. So the hydrogen ion is being added here. So when we add this here, we had 1 hydrogen, now we have 2 hydrogens. PO4 stays the same. This is a minus 2, we're adding a plus 1, so that becomes negative. So my base is, again, the one that accepts the proton. What it's called, after it accepts it, is called my conjugate acid. So this is the acid-base reaction going on in our system when you're adding either a strong base or a strong acid. So you're going to be using phosphate buffer in the solutions you're going to be testing. And what you're going to be doing is in one test tube, you're going to have water. The other one, you will have a buffer. You're going to add a strong acid to both the test tubes and see which one can you add more water to. Can you add more water to the water or the buffer? You'll know when you're going to get a pH change by adding a color indicator, which we did in part 1. We created that series of different colors to tell us when we have that pH change. You're going to repeat it again, and this time you'll use a strong base, and you'll add it to the water and the buffer, and see when you get that pH change. Which one can you add more to? the buffer or the water.
I have one test tube containing 5 mLs of water. My other test tube contains 5 mLs of a phosphate buffer. I'm going to add 2 drops of methyl orange to both of them. This is our color indicator, which will change colors depending on the pH of the solution. So we want to make sure that we mix these well, so our solutions are uniform in color. And then I'm going to add 1 drop of hydrochloric acid to each of the solutions, 1 drop at a time, and count how many drops it takes to make our solution change color. That's how we know that we have a new pH. So I'm putting 1 drop, and then I want to mix my solution. So we can see with 1 drop of our 1 molar hydrochloric acid in the water, we definitely have a color change. So now we're going to do our phosphate buffer and see how many drops of acid it takes to change the pH. Two drops in. Four drops. 5, 6, 7, 8. 14. We're starting to get a color change. 15. So it took about 15 drops for the color change. I've measured out 5 milliliters of water and 5 milliliters of our phosphate buffer. To both of the test tubes, I'm going to add our color indicator, phenylphthalein. Put in 2 drops. Make sure you mix it in. And now we're going to see which one can we add more of our strong base to. Our strong base we're using is sodium hydroxide. And we're going to add it drop-wise and count our number of drops. So the first one we're going to start with is water. So you put 1 drop and mix it up. So we have our color change with water and then phosphate buffer. 1 drop. And you want to make sure you mix it between each drop. 2 drops. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. Can see a little bit of pink appearing, but again, once we mix it up, it goes back to clear. It's 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 25 drops. For part 3, we'll be determining the pH of a solution using pH paper. So you can take a piece of pH paper off of the roll of paper. You'll dip it into your solution. The first one we're going to test is tap water. You want to get the paper wet, and then you're going to compare the color that the paper turns to the scale that's on the box of the pH paper. So you'll try to match this up where this matches up most closely. So looking at this example here, the number it looks most closely to is number 7. The next solution we're going to test is sodium bicarbonate, also known as baking soda. And baking soda, as you know, is a solid. So any solid materials that you're going to test the pH, we need to make sure that we dissolve those in water. So I'm going to take a little bit of this, dissolve it into my deionized water. Because one thing that's important to remember is that an acid is something you put it in water, and if it's aqueous solution, produces hydrogen ions. That's how we know we have an acid. A base is something you put it in water, and if it produces hydroxide ions, we know we have a base. So then we'll take a piece of our paper, dip it in our solution, and then we'll compare to our color chart. And then you're going to compare the colors here. Which color does it match most closely? So when we start at 0, it's the bright red going across. Then down to the bottom at 7 is the lighter green, and then we're comparing these darker greens. Where do you think this one fits most closely on our pH scale? And our pH scale, again, will tell us whether we have an acid or a basic solution. The last solution we'll be determining the pH of is an antacid. So this is a solid. So again, with the solid, we must dissolve it in water. Antacid is something you might take if you need to neutralize your stomach acid. You have hydrochloric acid in your stomach that's used to digest food. Sometimes we have a little bit of excess, and we might take an antacid to kind of counteract that. So I'm just going to dip my paper in here and then compare to my color chart to determine, is the salt that dissolved in here, is it producing hydrogen or hydroxide ions? It is an acid or a base? So I'm comparing along my color chart. Where do you think this color matches the best?